But Palumbo, Yodel Hair really messed up when you snubbed your noses at us and offered to join the new WCW, the Elite Group. We gave you your chance, and now in greed, Buff the Stuff in the total package known as Totally Buffed are going to take your titles, and we're going to put you out just like we did Goldberg! So Palumbo, Yodel Hair's title reign begins to end right here tonight because you're out of your league. Come on down here, kid.
Boy, he never lacks for confidence, feeling that he's going to destroy this young man here and that it's going to be a cakewalk at WCW Green for the World Tag Team Championship.
Proudly displaying one half of the WCW World Tag Team Champions with the belt in hand. Chuck Palumbo to the ring. We take you back to Super Brawl Revenge on Sunday night when Palumbo and O'Hair won the Battle of the Natural Born Thrillers. They defeated Sean Stasiak and Mark Shindrack, and as a result, they remain on top of the tag team world. They are the reigning WCW World Tag Team Champions. Palumbo and O'Hair, however, must go into the ring and must defend those titles at Greed on March the 18th against Lex Luger and Buff Bagwell, Totally Buffed.
And the total package said right there, Mike, that Chuck Palumbo early in his career was emulating the total package. I don't think that was it at all. I think he was trying to run down the total package.
I think that probably was the case, but whatever. In the mind of the total package, Lex Luger, he is going to use that imitation in his mind as extra incentive, I would think, not just in this match, but also at Greed when he and Bagwell go for the tag team titles.
How about the fans chanting of Goldberg? They'll never forget not only what Goldberg meant to WCW, but how he was run out of here on a rail by Ric Flair.
And that begs us to ask the question. With the new ownership of WCW boiling down to the last couple of weeks or the last couple of days before there's a major announcement about the new owners, how are they going to take that into account? The loss of people like a Goldberg, like a Kevin Nash last Sunday when they grade the jump of the boss, Ric Flair.
Great drop kick by Palumbo, and he runs over to the package with a running lariat. Boy, Chuck Palumbo, and understandably so, is fired up here against Lex Luger.
And Luger begging off, doing anything that he can to stop this offensive onslaught of the youngster Palumbo.
Charles Robinson, the referee, checking with the total package. Obviously, he's fine, begging off, trying to buy some time. Slow down the momentum here of Chuck Palumbo. The World Tag Team Championship bout is set for WCW Greed. Now, a lot of confidence behind the team of Totally Buffed. Everyone can understand why, because they are firmly entrenched in Ric Flair's Magnificent Seven.
And again, keep in mind that Ric Flair, the boss, has banned Sean O'Hair, Chuck Palumbo's tag team partner, from coming to the ringside area for this match against the total package, Lex Luger.
And let's not also forget what we heard backstage moments ago. Ric Flair wants to make sure that Scott Steiner focuses on Diamond Dallas Page, and that means Animal and Rick Steiner are here somewhere. Hugh Morris is going to have more than one problem here tonight, Mike.
Well, it's pretty obvious that Ric Flair has sent his bodyguard, his sergeant-at-arms, Road Warrior Animal, and the dog-faced gremlin Rick Steiner. I don't know if it's to try and take care of Hugh Morris before the match or some kind of strategy during the bout that is yet to come tonight here on Thunder when Hugh Morris faces Big Papa Pump Scott Steiner.
Chuck Palumbo in a world of trouble here as the total package focuses on the lower back. This is vintage Lex Luger weakening the lower back, enabling now, if he can get him in, that human torture rack to be the end of the match. There's a belly-to-back suplex once again on the lower back, hitting hard, cover, and Chuck Palumbo, with a lot of pain on his face, kicks away in two.
But you can't question the soundness of the strategy of the total package, Lex Luger. If you're going to use a finishing move like the torture rack, wear down your opponent. Work on the lower back area, just like Luger's doing against Palumbo.
Sound strategy has been one of the hallmarks of the total package. one of the reasons behind the longevity of his career. And now Palumbo with stiff right hands sends the package down, and that one rocked the head of Lex Luger.
We've been talking about it for several months, the effectiveness of those right hands from Palumbo, and they paid off there. Luger answers with a big scoop and slam.
Power slamming out of the right side ropes, enough to do a pose. He says that's it, and it usually means the torture rack, Mike.
And now motioning to the crowd that it is time to take Palumbo up in the rack. Look at how arrogant Luger is. How is he even talking to the fans?
Palumbo, one, two, three.
He did it.
My goodness, where did that come from?
How many times have we seen the total package posed after a power move, but it just backfired? That has to be the biggest win in the singles career of Chuck Palumbo. But now look at Luger. There's the torture rack. Oh, I can tell you that Chuck Palumbo is not feeling like a winner now.
And now Sean O'Hare's down. He ducks the clothesline, and he nails Lex Luger. He was barred from ringside during the match, but nothing's going to stop him right now.
Fortunately for Palumbo, O'Hare comes down to make the save. And now, who's that? It's Bagwell that just pulled Luger, his partner, out of the ring.
Running away now, Buckley Bump. Luger made a critical mistake, and Chuck Palumbo made a veteran move to get the inside credit for the win. There they are, the World Tag Team Champions, waiting for Totally Bumped, coming up at WCW Green.
Fame is the goal of every warrior who steps into the ring. Fortune is his reward for destroying all challengers. In the end, what they crave most is power.